So this is what I said. In today's session, we will understand very quickly the history of money. What is the purpose of money? What are the different channels of money? I mean, how can money, where do you get money from or where you can keep money? How does money circulate in the system? I mean, what happens to the money? And I will tell you all very quickly what is the difference between the formal and the informal sources of money, which we will cover in the third point, which is over here. So let me start with this. And most of you all would have also studied it in school, would know about it. But let me just tell you all about the history of money, okay, or the evolution of money. So money is almost a 3000 year old concept. Okay, 3000 to 3500 years back is when money actually started being recognized as a value of exchange. Okay, what did it start with? Money was never in paper form at the beginning. It started with a concept called barter. Okay, you can see the cow over here. Now, all of you all would know what is barter, but let me explain it to you. So, barter is exchange of one good for another good. At that time, there was no money. Okay, so what happened? Say, for example, I was a farmer, okay, who had a cow, and I was growing, say, grains or rice. And you had cows with you. You were a shepherd, and you all had sheep with you, or cows with you, or buffaloes with you. Now you needed rice, and I wanted the buffalo. So how would it happen? We both would reach out to each other, and I would give you, and you would give me, and I would give you rice, and you would give me a buffalo, and I would exchange it. And this is how it would happen. So another example could be basically, a tailor and a farmer. So the farmer wants clothes and the tailor wants food. So it would go to the farmer, tell him, give me one bag of wheat or one bag of rice. And the farmer would tell the tailor, okay, give me, a shirt or a pant or so on and so forth. So barter is exchange of goods between two people who have the need for each other. Now you can imagine that it is not very, very convenient. And why do I say so? It is not very convenient. Say, for example, you didn't need, first of all, you need to figure out, or you need to find out two people who need one or two goods for each other. What if I don't need clothes, or if I don't need the buffalo, or I don't need the rice? What do I do? How will I find out two people like that? The other part is, how do I transport it? I can't be sending 5 cows, 10 cows. How do I send cows? How do I take the grain? How do I store? Then all of these goods are also perishable. I cannot keep rice for 1 year. I cannot keep milk for, more than 3-4 days. I cannot keep vegetables for more than 3-4 days. So perishability was a problem. Exchangeability was a problem. Storage was a problem. So barter, in that sense, while it started out, but it was not a very, very efficient way of transacting.
So where does the bank keep all this money? Any idea you'll have? What happens? So much cash we go and deposit, like 10,000, 5,000, somebody deposit 1 lakh. Where do they keep all this our money? How do they give us when we want? You thought about it? I also don't know. I mean, I don't know, where does all this cash go? Like in the evening, there are these vans. Like, do they take the money and go to Delhi and give it to Narendra Modi so that he can keep it safely? Like, where does all the money of the consumers go? And then how do you get it whenever you want?
Okay, so there are two ways. So one is each branch keeps some cash based on his requirement. So you're right, Michelle. Okay. So every branch knows how much cash they should keep. So for example, if tomorrow the customers come and withdraw some money, at that time they can't tell the customer ke, hamare paas paisa nahi hai. We don't have that much money. So each bank knows in its city or in its town or in its area what is the utilization of money. So they always keep that much cash with them. The second is extra money, they send it to the to their main head office, which in turn sends it to the Reserve Bank of India's currency chest. Okay. So Reserve Bank of India runs currency chests where all the money goes.
Okay. By truck, it must be going by a physical van, right? Yeah,
so they go by armored trucks with all security guards and everyone. So the money actually goes into a currency chest, and they have very specifications, because I know when I was working with the banks and we used to run currency chest, RBI tells you ke itna concrete hona chahiye, 3 feet ka wall hona chahiye, camera itna lagana chahiye, so many security guards have to be there, this is the procedure and all that. So the money, so there are three ways. One is the branch keeps some money, there is some money which is kept in the ATM all the time, and extra cash is sent to the currency chest.
Okay. And it's deposited and then, somewhere in some physical location.
Yeah. So the cash is kept in the currency chest only, it's there only. And what happens is then each bank then has its requirement for the time being. So for example, today State Bank of India requires more cash. So the currency chest will end up sending that all those extra notes to State Bank of India in its account.
Okay.
So like how you maintain an account with bank. Your bank, each bank maintains an account with Reserve Bank of India.
Okay. Nice.
So Reserve Bank of India is the banker to banks.
Correct. Yes.
So Reserve Bank of India is the banker to banks. Like I explained last time. Acha kids, last time I told you all to look at a currency note. Did you all look at the currency note? Uske upar kiska photograph hai? And usme kya likha hai?
What's written on the note? Anyone has a note, take out and read. What is written on the note?
So if you have a currency note, I told you all last time, ke read the note. It says, I promise to pay the bearer.
We have somebody also volunteer.
Who wants to read the thing? Yeah.
Please.
Reserve Bank of India. And there is Gandhiji also numbers.
Okay. And do you see the wordings, I promise to pay? Turn it and see.
For 10 rupees and some photos of my animals.
There's the Ashoka Chakra.
Show the
note of it. Perfect. So it will somewhere will be written, I promise to pay the bearer. So children, that is what our currency note of India looks like. It has, I think, 17 to 18 languages also. Piche, all our main languages of the country. You know, it will be in Gujarati, Marathi, English, Hindi, Punjabi, Telugu, Kannada. If you turn the note, there will be on the left-hand side, there will be 10 rupees written in different languages. So if you see, it's a very good concept. The currency note makes you feel very happy. It has the Gandhiji's photo, it has the Ashoka Chakra, it has the sign of the governor of the Reserve Bank of India, which says that this is 10 rupees, and if you use it, you will get you will get things equal to 10 rupees. So it is a promise which is there in the currency note. So yeah, very interesting, to look at all of these things. So yeah, look at the note very, very carefully, read everything. There are numbers which are given in each note. Each note has a unique number. No two notes will have the same number. If you hold the note like this, it will have some lines also. It will have a watermark. It will have a design. Those are all the security features. Sometimes when you go to a shop, you will see the shopkeeper looking at it like this. He'll look at it from far. He'll turn the note. Aage piche karega. What is he looking for? He's looking at those lines. He's looking at the watermark and all that. Hold it against the light, your note. You will see watermarks. Do it at home today when you go. So yeah, so done for the day. If there are no questions, please attempt the quiz. And yeah, I will see you again next Saturday.